Hello everyone, you're watching Bowl Sky and today we're going to prepare rasam. So let's begin. Take 3 tomatoes and cut the top portion of the tomatoes. Make sure the tomatoes are washed thoroughly before using. Make 2 to 3 vertical cuts on the tomatoes. This is done to make sure the tomatoes are cooked on the inside. In this recipe, the rasam is made to serve 2 people. Alter the quantity of the ingredients according to your requirements. Add the tomatoes into a heated heavy bottomed pan. Here, a heavy bottomed pan is used so that the tomatoes cook faster. Add 3 cups of water and allow it to boil for about 15 minutes until the tomatoes become soft and tender. Note that the skin will start to peel off. Transfer the tomatoes in a bowl. Retain the water for later use. This water can be used for the rasam as it will already have the flavor of the tomatoes. Allow the tomatoes to cool for about 5 minutes, peel the skin off from the tomatoes and mash them slightly to avoid big pieces in the rasam. Keep it aside. Now add 4 garlic cloves in a mortar. Here we are using garlic cloves with the skin on as it enhances the flavor of the garlic. You can also use peeled garlic cloves. Add a teaspoon of peppercorn in it. The peppercorn adds to the spiciness of the rasam. Then add a teaspoon of jeera, also known as cumin seeds, in the mortar. Pound them with a pestle into a coarse paste and keep it aside. Heat the retained water in the same heavy bottomed pan for about 2 minutes. Add the mashed potatoes and the pounded paste. Add salt according to your taste. Here we have added 1.5 teaspoon of salt. Add 1/2 a lemon size of tamarind. Tamarind gives a nice tangy flavor to the rasam. You can also use tamarind paste instead. Allow it to cook for about 8 to 10 minutes. Then add 2 tablespoons of rasam powder. If you do not have rasam powder, you can use sambar powder as well. Bring the rasam to boil. Meanwhile, add 2 tablespoons of oil in a heated tadka pan. Add a teaspoon of mustard seeds and jeera. This gives a good flavor to the rasam. Add a pinch of hing. This enhances the aroma of the dish. Add 8 to 10 curry leaves. No South Indian cooking is complete without adding curry leaves. Allow all the ingredients to splutter. Pour the tadka onto the rasam. Add 1/2 a cup of finely chopped coriander leaves. You can also add full strands of coriander. Keep in mind that the coriander must be washed thoroughly before use. Add 2 teaspoons of ghee to add to the aroma of the rasam. Transfer it into a bowl and serve the hot rasam with rice. You can now enjoy the dish. That's all in this video. Hope you like this tutorial. For more such videos, keep logging into Bowl Sky.